Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial, and if you don't know me, then hi, I'm Harry and I am a makeup lover. And if you do know me, then you probably have seen on my Instagram that I have been taking over the makeup world. Makeup has been a massive part of my life for such a long, long time. So this is something that I've not woke up and gone, oh hi, I'm gonna do some makeup tutorials today. No. I want to do this because it's a massive passion of mine and I just can't wait to get on YouTube and show you full proper tutorials and talk through step by step of what I love, what I don't love, and review the products so you guys can go out and buy them with confidence. So let's get this makeup tutorial started. So to start off, I'm going to prime my face, and I'm going to be priming with this Bee Venom by Venom Skincare. I've been using this now for a couple of weeks and I have to say, I'm obsessed. It's like a load of bees just stung into this product and they mixed in with some cream and you put it on your face and you know, it just feels like it's stinging, but feels like it's proper working, like pulling you back. And this cream is for anti-aging as well, and I love using it before I put foundation on. And then I'm also gonna go in with this Benefit Cosmetics Pore Professional, just to smooth out the pores in my nose and be snatched for when I put my foundation on. Benefit Cosmetics, you smashed this product. And then before I put my foundation on, I'm gonna just go in with some MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus Spray. Keep that skin looking hydrated. I love using them three products before I start any makeup look because it is so important. It's important because you don't wanna not use them products and then put foundation on, because then sometimes your skin can be so dry that then you put foundation on and the foundation goes streaky, and then you put bronzer on and then you can see that you can get like missing little lines. So it's so important, and I always recommend you prime your face and use things like the Pore Professional and the Fix Plus before starting any look. So for foundation today, I'm going in with the stunning Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. I have tried this once and I was pretty impressed. I took my little ass to Selfridges and I was like, honey, I heard that Kim Kardashian loves this foundation, and it was good enough for Kim Kardashian, it's good enough for Harry Derbidge. So I went there, went to Selfridges, bought it, she tested the skin, the colour match in the shop. So I did say to her, I like to be a little bit darker than my natural skin colour, because I do normally wear a lot of fake tan. So I did go a little bit of a shade light, darker. So I've gone for 6.25. This foundation was £40, which is, I personally think, well, I was about to say quite, but I think it's very, very expensive for a foundation. So I'm going to give you a complete honest review today, see if it is worth the money. So let's get going. I'm also going to mix this in my foundation as well. This is the MAC Cosmetics Strobing Cream in shade Peach Lit. Peach Light? Peach Lit? I'm not sure what that is meant to say, but it's one or the other. And I'm going to just mix a tiny bit of that into the foundation just to give it a smooth finish. And I'm going to take my Real Techniques brush in 101. the foundation is now set. Do I love this foundation? I do like this foundation. I don't hate it. I don't love it. I like it. I definitely think it really helps apply as well when you add the MAC Cosmetic Strobing Cream to the foundation, because it gives it that more of an easier blending out base, and adds that little tiny bit of shimmery glow as well. So I definitely think that helps as well. So I do recommend this foundation a lot, but I do think you can get the exact same for less of the price from other brands. Now I'm gonna go in with the Benefit. I love that name. This is the Benefit Boing Concealer. I have been using this for a couple of weeks. This is in shade number 2. And I have to say, I really, really like this, because when I put this on, it doesn't feel heavy. Some concealers can feel really, really heavy. And this doesn't at all. It actually feels really comfortable on the under eye and the eyelids as well. So I definitely recommend this. I'm gonna go in with a MAC 248 concealer brush, and I'm gonna just dab that lightly. I met this girl once, and she said to me, I kid you not, guys, she was like, oh my god, I never put concealer on my eyelids. Like, before I put eyeshadow on, I never put concealer on my eyes, because it makes the shadows go a funny colour. And I looked at her up and down, and seriously, I was like, honey, don't test me, because everybody in the professional game puts concealer on their eyelids before eyeshadow, because that then gives it an easier blend and sets the eyeshadow better. So don't test me. And just quickly, I'm gonna just set my face with the MAC Cosmetics Studio Fix powder in shade NC40. Rude. That's quite a dark colour normally in MAC, but I always find their powders come out lighter, so I do go up a shade, because that is pretty much probably my colour, so that is quite dark. With the foundations, I normally only have like an NC25 or an NC30, so I do go darker with the powders. And I'm gonna just take this Real Techniques brush. I love these brushes, they're super soft, and they are affordable as well, so that's a really, really good thing I love about Real Techniques. So I'm gonna just I think a lot of people are thinking, why is that boy that used to be on the television now doing makeup tutorials? This is not something that I've thought, oh, overnight I'm going to just go and start doing makeup tutorials. I've actually been in makeup for a long, long, long time by doing performances. So I've had to learn how to do stage makeup, television makeup. I've also worked with a lot of makeup artists and picked up loads of techniques of them. And I've also done a few little makeup courses, because, do you know what? It's actually been a massive passion of mine for such a long, long, long time. And I love doing it because I can feel creative and, you know, really be in my element in life, so that's why I'm doing it. I've also been really, really fortunate already to work with some amazing, amazing brands. But I want to be real with you guys. I want to use products that I think are truly the best, and I will tell you the best products, and I will also tell you products that I've used or been sent that I don't like. So I'm going to keep it 100% real with you guys, because I'm not going to lie to you and be like,
My name's Harry, and I love this product, and you can use Harry10 for 10% off your purchase at the checkout.
No, I'm gonna be 100% real with you guys, and listen, no judgment to people that do have discount codes and XYZ, because do you know what, if I truly want to work for a brand and I want to save you guys some money, then I will do it, but I'm not going to be lying to you, so I want to be 100% real with you guys, so that's that. So for eyes today, guys, I'm going to go in with one of my favourite palettes. This is the Kylie Cosmetics bronzed palette. I love this. It's such an easy palette to use. Sorry, it is a little bit dirty because I do use it a lot. So I really like this palette a lot, and I love her packaging. I think she has some sick packaging. And for brows, I'm gonna go in with the Benefit Kabrow. I love that. It's like,
bam, kabrow.
I'm here. And don't you mess with me, because my brows are on fleek, kabrow. I think that's such a great name. So yeah, after that, I'm gonna go in with the Kabrow and fill in my eyebrows. I'm also using the MAC 266 brush to fill them in. So I went ahead and filmed the other eye off camera because you didn't need to see it be done twice. and now I'm gonna go in with this really cute little contour palette, and this is by Makeup Revolution, which is a drugstore brand. Yes, a drugstore brand. I do use drugstore stuff sometimes. But I'm gonna go in with this, and I'm gonna just use it to chisel out the cheeks, probably with this color, and then just maybe set a nice little under eye with this. Definitely. And I'm going to take my MAC 168 brush and use that for the powder contour. Everything will glow for you. You'll get punched for the love club. For the love club. So now the contour is set, it's time to use my favourite product in the world. This is the Iconic London Illuminator. And if you've not heard of this, then you haven't been alive. This is what every beauty influencer is currently using. This is everyone's obsession, and people are going mad for it. And it literally is such a delight. It's a delight. It's a pleasure having this in a makeup kit, honestly. And I'm gonna use the shade called Shine. And I like this color because it's the lightest color they do. But I quite like this color because as a highlighter, I really like a highlight to be strong and pop. So the lightest one for me definitely does that job the most. They do three other shades as well. The other shade is called Original, and the other one, which is the darkest one, is called Glow. I do have all three of them, and I use all three of them for different things, but today I'm going to use Shine. So I'm going to literally show you what this is. It's literally, oh my god, have you seen such a beautiful thing? It's incredible. I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna use this hand because this hand is clean. And I'm gonna just show you guys what it does and how amazing it is. And then on a clean finger, I'm gonna literally just, like, my God. Do you see what I am seeing? That is literally like Jesus just came out of a bottle. It's Jesus. This is Jesus. The way I'm going to apply this is literally use that finger I've just done to just swell that in. Just go a bit off so it's not so strong, because this is a very, very strong highlight. I'm going to just tap, tap, tap until it looks like that. And I'm gonna just go along my cheekbone like that, and then the same the other side, maybe a little bit more. There we go. And then I'm gonna just take a tiny, tiny bit as well and just go above my eyebrows, because I do personally get a lot of shine above my eyebrows, so I like to keep a glow looking quite natural. So I'm going to use my Real Techniques sponge just to blend that out. I'm really sorry, it's a tiny, tiny bit dirty because I do use this quite a lot. And I'm going to just take the Fix Plus again and spray that so the sponge is damp. And then we are gonna blend this baby out. Like, do you see that? Like, whoa. Oh, honey. Iconic London. Just smashed it. And then just to highlight my lips, I'm gonna use the Kylie Cosmetics highlighter again in shade French Vanilla, and I'm gonna just go along the lips. And just to finish completely, we're gonna go back with the Fix Plus spray and spray this baby on. Hope you have enjoyed watching this, and thank you for watching, and make sure if you want to see more of this, then you've just got to scroll down there and hit that subscribe button. Oh, and while you're at it, don't forget to give it a little comment and a little thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I can't wait to see you all very soon. Bye, everyone.